Hi there, welcome to this next part of collections. In the previous part, we learned about array list, how can we work with array list, how can we declare array list, how can we get set and perform multiple operations on array list. Now it's time to learn about few properties of array list which are very important and are used at a regular basis. Let's have a look on all the properties that we are going to learn in this video. We will learn what is capacity. We will learn what is the count property, how to use this count property. We will learn is fixed size property. We will also learn about is read only property. Before everything, let's see about the capacity property of array list. Capacity property is used to get or set the number of elements that an array list can contain within same memory. So suppose you have declared an array list and you have inserted few values in that array list. Now that array list will contain some space in memory, and that size does not directly depends on the number of elements. That size may be more as compared to the elements. So capacity property tells us how many number of more elements can we insert in same memory. Capacity increases as we increase number of elements in array list. Whenever you will add new values or you will insert few other elements in the array list, then the capacity property will also get increased. Capacity returns an integer value. So basically it is a property which returns an integer type. Let's see the capacity property in the demo and let's open the Visual Studio code. Before that, let me create a new project. Let's open the project in editor. If I open the program.cs file and I declare a new array list, you know, to use the array list, we have to include a namespace which is system.collections. So suppose I'm going to declare an array list and the variable name is list. I can write it like this. Let me remove this console message and here let us see what is the capacity property. So console dot write line, I'm going to print the capacity and you will see what is the default value of this capacity when there is no element in the array list. Here you can see the capacity is 0 because there is no element, so there is no size in the memory. And capacity property tells us how many more elements can we insert in the array list. Let's add a new element in this array list. Now let's try the capacity. The capacity is 4. So since we have added only one element, but the capacity is 4, it means the array list is having a space in memory which is equal to 4 elements. So in the same memory which is currently used by ArrayList, we can insert 3 more elements. Let's insert 3 more elements over here. And now let us see what is the capacity now. Still you will see the capacity is 4. Since we have added 4 elements and the capacity is also 4, now if you will add one more element in the ArrayList, the capacity will get increased. Let's try that also. So I have inserted 5 elements, but the capacity earlier was 4. Now let's see what will be the capacity of this array list. Here it is 8. So the important point to understand is the size which is taken by the array list in memory, that is something which gives us the performance issue. So since we have only 5 elements, but the space in memory it is acquiring is equal to number of 8 elements. If you have large number of elements in your array list, then it will need more space and which will give you performance problem. So this was all about the capacity property. Now let's see about the second property of array list, which is count. Count is a simple property which is used to get the number of elements actually contained in an array list. Count also returns an integer value. Let's see it in the demo. So count property is basically used how many number of elements are actually exist in array list. So right now there are only 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the count of the array list will be 5. Let's try it. Here you can see the count is 5. If I remove few elements from the array list, then you will see the count will also get decreased, because it gives the actual number of elements which are available in array list. So now we have only 2 elements, that's why we are getting only 2 as an output. If you will increase the number of elements, the property will also get increased. So now it will return 3, which is correct. Okay, let's see the another property. Is fixed size. Is fixed size tells us whether an array list has fixed size or not. Is fixed size returns a boolean value. So basically we have different type of array list, and if you need to check whether your array list is of type fixed, it means the size of that array list is fixed somehow, and if you are using that is fixed property, it will return true or false. If the array list is of type fixed size, then it will return true, otherwise false. Let's try it. In fixed size. So let's press F5. Here you will see the output is false. It means our array list is not of fixed size. Now the question is how to make an array list of fixed size. Okay, so for that we have few methods which are available under array list. So array list dot fixed size. So basically this method is used to convert an existing array list into fixed size. And so suppose I'm passing the list over here and it will return one more array. I can store that array list in another variable. So let's give it a meaningful name, and suppose it is list 2. And now let's try the fixed size of this list 2 property. So on the first line we have written list 2, and on the second line we are writing list. So we will see what are the outputs of these properties. So for the list 2, you can see the property is true. It means this has fixed size. And what is the meaning of having fixed size? It means we cannot change the number of elements in that array list. If I try to insert one more element in list 2, list 2 dot add, and suppose I'm inserting one more value over here, you will see we will get an error while we run the program. We got an exception at this place. Exception has occurred, CLR system dot not supported exception. An unhandled exception of type system dot not supported exception occurred in system dot runtime dot exceptions. Okay, what is the error? Collection was of a fixed size. It means we cannot update the number of elements in array list. If I try to remove an element, to remove an element we have a method which is remove at, and this removes a particular element from a particular index. So suppose I want to remove an element from the first index, again you will see we will get an exception. It means the array list is of fixed size, but if I want to update the values in array list, suppose I want to update a value at first index and I want to make it 100, and let's put a breakpoint over here. Here there is no exception because we are not changing the size of array list, we are only updating the few values in existing size. So let's see whether value is also get updated or not. In list 2 we have all three values, and the second index which is the first is also get updated because we have updated the values over here. So this is how you can calculate your array type whether it is of fixed size or not, and this is how you can create a fixed size array list with the help of fixed size method of array list. Let's see about the is read only property. So this is similar to the is fixed size. Is fixed size was telling us whether the array list is of fixed size, and now the is read only will tell us whether the array list is only of read only type. Is read only tells us whether an array list is of type read only. Is read only returns a boolean value. So let's try this one also. So here if I comment these two lines for a while, and let me comment this line also, and here if I try is read only. So basically we have a simple array list, and this array list contains only three elements. And now I need to check whether the type of this array list is of read only or not. Let's press F5. Here you can see that we have a value false on the console screen. It means the current array list is not of read only type, because we can read the values, we can insert the values, we can perform all the operations. That's why this list is not of read only type. And how to make an array list of read only type? For that there is one more method. So we can use read only method. Now the type of the list 2 will be read only. We can use is read only. Let me remove this value also. We will try that later. And now let's press F5. Here you can see that the is read only property is giving true for the list 2. So since our list 2 is of type read only, that's why we are getting true. And the list which is the earlier, which is the first array list, this is not of read only type. That's why we are getting false from the is read only property. And now let's see what is the meaning of this read only. It means we can only read the values from array list. We cannot insert the values, we cannot update the values. If I try to update the value, suppose I want to update a value at first index and I want to make it 90. Let's press F5. We will get an exception. The collection is read only. It means we cannot update the values. And if I try to insert few values, then also I will get an error. But if I want to read the values from this array list, then I can read this with the help of list 2 and the index. So let's print the values. Just like this. If I press F5 now, you will see the value is available on console screen. So on the first index we have the value 2. That's why we are getting 2 here on the console screen. That's all in this part. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button of the video. Tell me your feedback in the comment section. Share this video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.